All right. Welcome to the new felting video. It's been a while since the last one, and I think the commonest comment I've gotten since that last one was how to create the template to decide, you know, like what shape it should be to fit your feet properly. So that's what we're doing today. I'm working with a new material this time. It is fabric drawer liner. Last time I used heavy duty plastic shelf liner. This is softer, but like a similar amount of flex. Hoping it will be adequate. It's got decent thickness and should hold up well in terms of creating nice smooth seams over the edges without, you know, moving around on me. So we'll see how it performs. All right, so I'm making boots today, whereas the last tutorial I was making shoes, but the general principles are still very much the same, just with a slightly different template. But you should be able to figure out the differences pretty easily. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is step, I guess I'll do it this way so you're not staring at the back of me. You're going to stand on your material and just do a basic outline around your foot. This isn't going to be where we're going to cut at all, it's just like a baseline to start with. So that's a foot. And actually, it's like not quite square enough, so we're going to ignore that. I'm going to try and line up a little bit more perpendicular to the template, because this is going to have to go out sideways quite a way. All right, don't worry about this being super exact. So now, the main step that we're doing here is to go out a reasonable distance from the edge of our foot. Depending on the type of wool you have, whether it's been washed, how specifically you felt it, it can shrink varying percentages in different directions. It might shrink more one direction than the other. I've seen up to 40% shrinkage before. You generally want to assume for about 30% just to be safe. So if you think about that, you want to go, you know, like consider your distance from the center of your foot out. You want at least a third beyond, which for most feet is going to be like roughly an inch and a half. If you go much beyond that, you may find that even when your wool is shrunk down as much as possible, it's still too big. So I generally stick with around an inch and a half. And sometimes I measure it, but really I've kind of just gotten used to eyeing it. So I do follow the shape of my foot. I don't just make a perfect oval, but it's still, when you come out that far, makes a pretty vague shape. So you don't have to worry too much about being super exact. Okay, so if you just wanted to make a slipper, this would be adequate, because you're going to felt around both sides of the resist. You could cut this out, you could felt around both sides, you would, you know, be able to make a cut right here and end up with a pouch you can slip your foot in and do your finished felting down to a custom size. For shoes, you would want to add a little bit of an ankle. Since I'm doing boots, I'm adding a significant amount. So what I do now is lay my foot sideways, or my leg sideways, and decide how far up my leg I want this boot to go. This is going to be a pretty cold weather boot. I do want it to come up probably to mid-calf. And so initially here I can just do a rough trace of my calf. just like we did with the inside of our foot. And then we want the same amount of distance around the calf. Looks about right. So this is the outer edge of my template for one boot. But we're not just making one, we're making a pair. So what I'm going to do now is fold this over on itself and double it, which luckily I did just far back enough on the material to have the full length without having to scoop my pattern down. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this real quick and get it folded over. Scissors. Trace this so it doesn't slide around on me while I'm cutting and give me an inaccurate cut. Even though this is curly. Let's see if you can see all of it. Yes, good. That is the shape of my template for my boots. So if you wanted ankle shoes, you'd chop it here. If you want longer boots, you make longer boots. If you want slippers, feel free to stop here or see the other templates for different shapes of slipper. So now I'm going to get my set up arranged so that I'll be ready to lay out my wool and start felting. Maybe I can leave that halved. If you're used to making smaller stuff, you definitely want to make sure you have enough absorbent material down for doing boots. It's a much larger, messier situation than just a bowl. And I think I'm going to grab like a trash bag or something to lay down to make it easier to flip. Alright, here's the mess of my available wool, which I just attempted to weigh just on a normal scale. It said 4.8 pounds. I'm not sure how accurate that is. I will do a finished weight on the boots and put that in the description, just to give you an idea of thickness. So right now I'm just sorting all my bats by color. As you can see, I've got quite the variety of type and quality. Some of this is stuff from my own sheep or wool that I was gifted years ago, and some of it is, you know, nice fluffy white professionally carded stuff that I purchased. So anyway, here's my little piles. I'll probably be doing the nice white on the inside, and then using some of the lower quality wool on the middle layers. and then I'll have to make an aesthetic decision about what to do on the outside. But that's everything separated. I've got a nice big pot of hot water and soap ready to go. And it's not going to be long enough, is it? Okay, I have to cut this bag down the edges, use that to flip on